Leaders, questions. I call on Deputy Keller.
Minister, last night we saw the most moving emotional testimony that a person could witness, that of Mr. Praveen Halappanavar, talking about his wife Savita's life and her tragic death. It was truly harrowing, Minister. He also spoke about his concerns of an independent inquiry that the government is proposing. Now, Minister, the Taoiseach met with the Indian ambassador. The Irish ambassador has met with the Indian government. Yet nobody from this government has met with Mr. Halappanavar. We now could have a situation where the government could be in open conflict with Savita's family in a court of law to try and access medical records or retain medical records so that they can go on with an inquiry or an investigation that nobody wants or has any confidence in. Now, Minister, how can we continue with this investigation? The family don't want it. Some of your own colleagues don't want it at this stage. And our President has told you it is clearly wrong.
Sorry, Deputy, we shouldn't engage the President in this.
I don't intend to engage the President. I'm just quoting what has been said. He is reflecting the views.
He's
reflecting the views of the Irish people.
We understand the Constitution.
The President said,
the Constitution, respect the Constitution position of the President.
Well, Kieran Corley,
he's just reflecting
the views of the Irish people. And clearly, I'm saying that the government should listen. Now, Minister, what I'm calling on this government to do is for the Taoiseach to personally intervene and meet with Praveen to find out exactly what investigation would satisfy his concerns and that of his family. Everybody in this House wants to get to the truth of the matter. Everybody wants to find out what happened and what can be done to avoid such similar circumstances in the future. But quite clearly, Minister, nobody has confidence in this investigation, and I mean nobody. So I'm asking that the Taoiseach would intervene, sit down and discuss and come to an accommodation so that we, as a Parliament, are not seen to be in conflict with a man who's lost his husband, who we could be dragging through the courts to access or retain her medical records. It is just unsightly and unbelievable, Minister, that we're still, at this stage, talking about this very tragic issue. How much more must this family endure to try and come to the truth of what happened to Savita in Galway? Minister, ask the Taoiseach to intervene in a personal, human way, without the cameras, without the microphones, and sit down and try and find an accommodation that everybody can be satisfied with.
Thank you, Minister.
First of all, I've read and heard the comments made by Uachtarán na hÉireann. I want to say they're considerate, thoughtful,
reflective,
and humane.
Under Article 1381 of the Constitution, the President is not answerable to the Dáil, so please respect that. Thank you.
The spokesperson raised the issue, and
I'm correcting that
in relation to the President's comments. That's all I wish to say in relation to that. Just let me say that the issue here, and anybody who has heard Mr. Halappanavar speaking or being interviewed on television last night, could not fail to be moved by what must be the immensity of his grief and his shock and his trauma at what happened to his wife. And anyone who has sat beside a loved one as they die would know that the kind of experience that he has had must be enormously and tremendously difficult for him. And that is why I think the thoughts of everybody in Ireland, from the first citizen to every other citizen, is with him and with his family and friends in Ireland and in India. Let me say that the HSE is responsible for appropriate inquiry when deaths occur in hospital which require investigation. And that with reference to your reference to the records of the HSE, the HSE, like any other institution or hospital, or indeed any institution, is legally responsible for the proper maintenance of records. Obviously, Mr. Halappanavar's legal advisor has expressed views in relation to that, but I think you would know, as a health spokesperson, that the HSE also has responsibilities in relation to records. But let us cut to the net point. This is about the safety and the care of women, so that this episode or some tragic happening like this does not occur again. So this is what it's about. It's about the care, protection and safety of women when in hospital in relation to childbirth and in relation to pregnancy. And it's the duty of the HSE to find out and see in relation to that hospital if there were unsafe practices, and that those practices would be amended and strengthened so that women going into that hospital, or indeed any other hospital in this country, could be assured that their safety and care is the primary consideration, and that structures are in place in relation to that. Just let me say as well, and I welcome the fact that you suggest that this should not take place in a controversial, adversarial mode. Given the grief of her husband, which is so understandable to everybody, nobody wants to add any additional pressure or stress to that grief that he is undergoing. I think it's important that he would understand that that's the view, I think, of everybody in this house. Now, the chairman of the inquiry, Professor Sir Saba Ratnam Arul Kumaran, is an internationally renowned expert. He is entirely independent. Secondly, the other members of the team, the inquiry team, are also nationally and internationally renowned. It is important from the point of view of the safety of women that it's established what happened, and that if hospitals in Ireland need to move immediately to make appropriate provision in relation to securing the safety and well-being of women, that should be done. And that, I think, Deputy, is the most important issue, as well as tending as best we can as a country to the grief of her husband her family.
Deputy.
Well, Minister, the government has obligations and duties as well. The HSE can look after itself in terms of its own inquiry. But quite clearly, the family of Savita are not going to cooperate with a HSE investigation. So you're going to have open conflict. There is going to be huge difficulties placed on this family in trying to get to the truth of what happened to Savita in Galway. Now, Minister, we do not want to raise this in a political, adversarial way, but we certainly don't want the state to be in an adversarial way with the bereaved family. And that clearly is what's going to happen. So, Minister, look, I'm just asking for one last time, for personal intervention behind the scenes, for the Taoiseach to meet with Praveen and the family and legal representatives to find out some way of addressing the concerns in a meaningful way that will establish the truth and will also satisfy the family about its independence. And a commission of inquiry could be that way. The HSE will carry out its own investigation anyway with regard to its internal workings. But what we want to do is try and establish a commission that will satisfy everybody. And clearly, Minister, your response will not satisfy Praveen, family or the broader Irish public.
Thank you.
So I'm just urging you, Minister, one last time, please, for the behind-the-scenes discussions with Praveen and the family to try and find a way and a mechanism to deal with this, and our suggestion of a commission of inquiry. And this won't prejudice the outcome of anything.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Taoiseach is quite entitled and should meet with Praveen and the family to discuss their concerns. In fact, it should have already happened.
Can I just say that every effort will be made by the government to do everything that we can to support Savita's husband in his understandable deep grief. We heard him speak last night. I don't think anybody who heard him speak could fail but to be moved by it. But can I just say, and you acknowledge there yourself, that the hospital and the HSE must know what happened so that they can ensure, immediately that there are no further risks to the life of women in hospital. That, as well as supporting her grieving family, that is also something that is owed to the women of Ireland and that the women of Ireland want, Deputy. You may disagree, but the safety of women in a hospital during pregnancy, during delivery, and in the unfortunate event of a miscarriage, which happens at an early stage in a very high proportion of pregnancies, it is most important that we give reassurance to the women of Ireland and their families and their friends and partners that they are as safe as possible in our hospitals. That is one of the focuses of what the government is doing, as well as assisting the family and the husband of Safita as well as we can. And all options, Deputy, are open. Just let me say to you, you're speaking there about a commission of inquiry. Can I just caution a word that this chamber should not rush down the legal adversarial road at this point? When Judge Moriarty first started on his tribunal, he said that it would be finished within 12 months. In fact, it took almost 13 years. Now, we also have had, on numerous occasions, both when you were in government and indeed on occasion since this government has been formed, ministerial inquiries. Now, if you want to go the road of a full tribunal, you are really talking. Just let me take it.
Sorry,
you made reference to a commission of inquiry. Can I just say that I think we need to focus on the safety and welfare of women. In that context, anybody who is responsible for running an institution like a hospital has a responsibility to find out as quickly as possible, if only on health and safety grounds, to see is there something that needs to be done or amended to actually increase the safety and protection of women who are in delivery, who have gone in the context of a miscarriage, or who are otherwise being cared for in the context of pregnancy.
Thank you. I'd ask members to please understand that there's a time limit, and I am obliged to ask members to adhere to that time limit.